Welcome, everybody, to Showtime SPL. I'm Ed Lester.
I'm Rich Tornetta.
And this is Sounds Fun. We're kind of taking a scientific look at sound and the aspects of sound, right?
Yeah.
Now, sound is energy. Have you heard that saying before?
Yeah, I have, but the only thing with me is I've actually heard almost two definitions of sound.
Okay.
One is the one that, I guess, physics is involved, you know, the vibrations and that kind of thing. Yeah. The other one is what everybody else is accustomed to, which is the vibrations through the air. They hear things, and that's considered sound.
Right.
So there's, like, almost two conflicting definitions.
A little sketchy on that. Can we look that up?
Ah, we have our trusty little tablet here.
Technology.
Ah. Let's just say physics definition of sound.
According to Wikipedia, in physics, sound is a vibration that propagates as a typically audible mechanical wave of pressure and displacement through a medium such as air or water. In physiology and psychology, sound is the reception of such waves and their perception by the brain.
Aha, perception by the brain, okay.
Right. I think we want to focus a little more on the physics definition.
Sure.
A medium like air.
It's a good place to start.
Propagates through air. It's logical. You know, that's what we're accustomed to the most, right?
Yeah.
So we want to kind of show a little visual of how we can vibrate something on one side and travel through air to something else.
I have an idea.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm a drummer, right?
Yes.
And I'm used to vibrations. I have to wear earplugs because of so much vibration. I got a drum set at the studio.
Yeah.
Why don't we start banging on drums?
That's perfect.
Okay, great.
Yeah, let's go to the studio. Hey guys, we're here in the studio and we're gonna observe how sound travels through air. We have Rich on the drums over there, and every time he hits one of the drums, a wave is gonna travel through the air, like a domino effect, and interact with the diaphragm on this bucket. So when he hits the low tom, we have a vibration. And when he hits the snare, we also have a vibration. But the biggest vibration probably comes from the kick drum. Now when he puts them all together, that was intense. I forgot how good you were on the drums.
So did I. I hit things with sticks. But anyway, so I didn't see it when we were actually there, but I watched the video footage back and I noticed that the rice was bouncing on that diaphragm that we had. So what exactly happened there?
Well, every time your stick hits one of the drum heads, it's vibrating the drum head. And that pushes on the air molecules that are right near it.
Right.
Those air molecules then transfer their vibration and push on other air molecules.
Like a domino effect, like a chain reaction.
And all the way in line till we get to the drum, or to the bucket.
To the diaphragm. So that's kind of like what our ear, you know, eardrum vibrating.
Yeah.
That's how we hear sound.
Our eardrum is hairs. The bucket is a plastic diaphragm. So when that air pressure pushes, it goes up and down, and we see the rice bounce up and down.
Kind of reminds me of a subwoofer. Like if my snare drum is a vibrating diaphragm and a subwoofer is a vibrating diaphragm, it's compressing the molecules in front of it and creating a vacuum when it comes back in, really fast, right?
And we see this in SPL cars and trucks all the time, like EXO up in Maine.
That's right, yeah.
You see the doors every time the woofers come out, compression wave pushing the doors out. Every time the woofers go in, it's a vacuum pulling the doors back in, doing it very fast, obviously, 35 times a second if you play 35 hertz, you know?
Right, so it stands to reason that if we could do this with air, something that can be compressed, then we could do it through water, which can't be compressed.
Can't be, but that means it's more efficient. It's a more efficient transfer of energy.
Okay, so like dolphins, whales, sonar.
Exactly, yeah. Sonar can reach 220 dB underwater. The limit in air is 194 dB.
Okay.
So the efficiency. Now, I had a video, Sound Bass and Water. You can go back and check it out. It's pretty cool. The displacement of the woofer, you can see it pushing on the water.
Okay.
So it was pretty cool, you know, but I would like to get the woofer a little bit more submerged. Maybe that'll show the effect a little bit better. We'd have to find a place to submerge it, though.
I have a bathtub.
Oh, yeah. Is your wife home?
She's at work.
Time to play in the bathtub.
Let's go.
Okay, we're here in this bathroom. No, not to wash the woofer after it got dirty, but to study how sound travels through a liquid.
Yes, sound does travel through a liquid. As a matter of fact, up to 4 times faster than it does through air. If you've ever been in a pool and underneath your buddy snaps his fingers, it will appear to your eyes and ears as if the sound is arriving almost instantly. And that is because we are used to hearing a sound and seeing the action take place at a much farther distance apart. So when you're underneath the water and it happens 4 times faster, it sounds like the sound arrives instantly to your ear.
Now, snapping your fingers is a higher frequency. We're gonna play some lower frequency tones through our test amplifier to our test box of science.
Yes, that was every bit as much fun as it looked.
I had a lot of fun.
I had too much fun in the water. Okay, so the one thing I noticed was when the sub was going at one cycle, which is basically one time in and out, like one hertz, okay, there was a lot of kinetic energy.
It was
pushing the water.
Sloshing it.
The power was amazing, okay? Yeah. So when I looked at it, it kind of reminded me of being at the water park. You remember that? You know the wave pool?
Yeah, yeah.
Can that be considered sound?
By the physics definition, I would say so. We're still transmitting energy. The wave pool is a very low frequency, but even one hertz from the woofer, just because we can't hear it, doesn't mean it's not sound.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
And now at the higher frequencies, we were able to see a little bit better, a cleaner wave. We saw interference waves.
What's interference?
So we saw the clean waves, right? So when the woofer moved and we saw the first wave come out, very clean. Like ripples in a pond.
Like when you drop a pebble kind
of
thing?
Yeah, clearly see the crests. As soon as it reflected off the sides of the tub, it came and interfered with the wave still coming out of the woofer.
Right.
When it interfered, the geometry changed. We saw...
Oh, those little diamond patterns?
Exactly. Oh, okay. So we saw interference patterns. We hear that, but we don't always see it. Here we got to see it.
I see. So that's basically a way to visualize waves, right?
Exactly. Visualize it. Keyword. Give me an idea. An application. Build an enclosure. If you're an SPL guy, want to test your enclosure, build it, fill it with water, play some music and see.
That's smart, because when it's air, you can't really see it.
Exactly.
With water, you get to visualize it. All right, so we've done air, we've done water. I guess the next step would be solids, right?
Yeah. Solids are going to be a little tough to show, visualize.
Right,
any ideas?
Well, in prison movies, I've seen guys like, you know, they tap on the pipes, you know, and do like Morse code.
Yeah.
But
exactly.
I don't have any pipes in my house that are metal. All mine are PEX plastic pipes and PVC and stuff.
We can always take a field trip and go find something.
Okay, let's get our coats on.
Let's go.
Okay, so when my buddy Ed hits this railing with his hammer, I should be able to hear it through the steel. I heard it. And the best part is, I actually heard it sooner in my left ear than in my right ear. And that's because sound travels 18 times faster through steel than it does through air. It's very cool.
So we got to experience sound through a solid.
Yep.
We didn't quite see it, but it was still pretty cool.
It was cool, but after all the visually stunning things that we've made in these videos, it's almost like it. You can't see it. I want to see something prettier, really cool. What if we took like a liquid and merged it with a solid somehow? But I don't know if there's a way to do that.
Different type of solid.
Yeah.
Like a non-Newtonian fluid or something.
I've always wondered about them. Could we use that?
Yeah, definitely.
All right. What would we do? Like just put it on a sub and see if it vibrates?
Sounds good to me.
All right. I guess we're going back to the lab. Welcome back, guys, to the Tech Fun Laboratory.
Now, we got this great material. It's a non-Newtonian fluid. What we're going to do with that is put it on our test woofer and play some tones through it. See if we can visualize sound through a solid. Now, this fluid, it acts like a fluid when there's little to no energy applied, but as soon as you apply energy, it acts more like a solid. It's wonderful.
Okay. That was the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life.
I know. I could watch that all day.
Can we please go watch those videos again?
Well, let's do this thing. We got the thing to do here.
All right. So pretty much what I saw was a liquid.
Yes.
But when force was applied, it became a solid.
Did its thing. I know.
That's mind-boggling. It's like gets your thoughts all trapped like in a bottle, you know?
It was so cool to look at.
So how much force is required for something like this? It's got to be a lot. And what kind of force?
Okay, I calculated this beforehand, so ready for this. Now, when we have a big woofer, not even our test woofer, a big like 18-inch woofer with a heavy... Exactly, like the one you got here.
This
big guy here. This big woofer, 2 joules. That's it. So a 9mm bullet is 500 joules.
What?
You would think, yeah. So our test woofer is a lot lower than that.
Big,
so
it's a lot of...
That's all that's needed to get the effect through the non-Newtonian fluid.
Man.
I know. So you don't need a whole lot of energy. Even your finger pushing on the fluid can...
Oh, right. Maybe it's stiffen up. That's right.
So not a whole lot of energy, you know?
Oh, these videos were so cool.
I know. I'm going to watch it. I'm going to share it, guys. I'm going to share this to everybody I know.
Please share this video. Absolutely.
It looks so cool. Thank you guys for supporting me so much already. One guy that supports me, Jeff Smith. I'm going to try and give something back. Little excess power t-shirt. Which
not that one.
No. This probably smells. Probably got Ooblecks all over it.
Boob what?
Ooblecks. You know, from the non-Newtonian fluid. That's the nickname of the creatures. And
the Spider-Man symbiote thing that was jumping out.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. It's called a Ooblecks?
Yeah, Ooblecks.
Oh, okay.
Ooblecks. It looks so cool. Thank you, guys. Check out Rich's channel as well.
Technically Fun. I got some videos up. They're doing really well. You guys have been great. Definitely come and share them and follow. It's been so far, it's been great.
Stick around. We got more episodes coming soon. And remember, if it sounds fun,
it probably is.